This is the Fox 5 Rev Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
Good evening. Welcome inside the Rev Zone, coming to you from inside the MGM Grand Garden Arena. Kevin Bolinger alongside Running Rebels head coach Marvin Menzies. UNLV with a big win against Illinois on Saturday night. Certainly not a Mona Lisa, maybe a little more paint by numbers, but a win's a win.
I'll take that win any way we can get it, you know, especially at this time of year, and especially against a team of that caliber. They're going to be really good in conference, I think. They've got some young guys that are just getting better in their guard spots, and they've got the big kid that can shoot it, Finke, and I mean, they have some really good players, and we were able to weather the storm, I would say, but made some good decisions down the stretch and carried it into a victory.
Let's show you the highlights in this one as we start breaking down the Illinois game.
A hyped-up crowd on the Las Vegas Strip as the Running Rebels in Illinois went toe-to-toe with the MGM. UNLV got off to a quick start. Off the inbounds pass, Brandon McCoy throws it down. Then JoJo Mooring hits a follow-away jumper as the Rebs open the game on a 12-2 run. Shakur Justin gets the offensive rebound and put back. That was followed by a three by Mooring and a strong move to the hole by Travell Beck. Things were looking solid as UNLV built a 10-point lead. But Justin picked up his third foul with 5:30 to go in the first, and Illinois climbed back in it and took the lead on this reverse lay-in by Kipper Nichols. The Rebs dug deep and answered back. McCoy inside, he gets the hoop in the arm. In transition, they get it to Beck for the lay-in. The steal by McCoy. He pokes it to himself and he heads the other way for the bucket. Then off the miss on the corner three by Chris Clyburn, Anthony Smith flies through for the follow slam. The Running Rebels led 45-36 at the break. The second half was a whistle fest early as Illinois had seven fouls called against them in the first 4 minutes to put UNLV in the bonus. But the Rebels were cold from the field and the Illini chipped away and took the lead on this alley-oop. UNLV didn't make their first field goal of the second half until this Beck lay-in 8 minutes and 10 seconds into the second half. It was tight for nearly the rest of the game. McCoy turns it over, and Damonte Williams scores on the other end to give Illinois a 3-point lead. But McCoy got back in it. The bucket and the foul. Then the great feed to the big man. He gets the flush. Jordy Johnson and Mooring come up with big threes down the stretch. That gave UNLV some breathing room. The capper came off the steal. The fast break and Amari Hardy, the alley-oop over to Justin, and that put it away. UNLV went to the line 48 times compared to 15 for Illinois. Mooring pours in 27, and McCoy notches another double-double with 22 and 10 as the Running Rebels pick up a big win, 89-82.
We just knew how hard they played defensively. You know, this probably was the best defensive team we've seen so far. And we knew they were going to get out and pressure the ball. And it was just the guard's job to keep as much pressure on the defense as possible. And that was just by attacking.
All right, so a fast start this time by the Running Rebels in the first half. And that was nice to see that things were clicking right out of the gate.
You know, we needed that. I think we knew there was going to be adversity. We didn't know when it was coming. It's just a quality team that is not going to quit. I mean, Brad's teams always fight until the very end. So it was good to see that when we did get that punch thrown at us, we were able to kind of absorb it and throw back a punch of our own.
The one thing that hurt, Shakur Justin got into a little foul trouble, picked up three fouls. And you can tell this team's a lot different with him off the court than it is on. He brings a certain amount of intensity to
yes.
that kind of carries over to the other guys.
You know, he's got that old Jedi master, you know, kind of persona, and it's a calming influence, but it's a don't mess with me influence also. So guys, you know, play better with him on the court just because he's such a great teammate, rebounder. He can score the ball. He brings a lot to the table, man. So to have him out there during the final minutes of the game was critical for us.
So we get to the second half, and the first 8 minutes, very strange in the sense that UNLV didn't get their first field goal until 8 minutes and 10 seconds in, but you were also in the bonus 4 minutes and 5 seconds into the
right.
second half. So they kind of canceled each other out a little bit, but certainly not the most orthodox way that you would see a game.
No, and we wanted to get to the free throw line. We know that they how aggressive they play. We wanted to go body to body off the bounce. We wanted to make sure that we you know, drew fouls when we could the right way. And luckily that was the way they called the game. They don't always call it that way. So, but it went in our favor tonight. And we got to the free throw line a lot. I think we had 48 attempts and I wish we would have shot a little better from the free throw, but we'll get there.
We've talked a lot last year and the first part of this year about winning time.
Yeah.
You had two overtime games last week where things didn't go your way. This time we were into winning time and your team responded and played really well in that last 3 minute stretch.
You know, it's you got to practice, you know, what's going to be in front of you in order to be efficient at it. And we had the two games where, be quite honest, we didn't practice a lot of winning times in practice. And when we got forced into them in the games, we didn't respond the way that we should. So we obviously, you go back to the drawing board, you put yourself in situations and scenarios and practice to replicate, okay, here's the time and score. Here's, you know, what is the emphasis in these last 3 or 4 minutes? And having those practices, I think enabled the guys and the experiences of the other games enabled them to be a little bit more composed. So they're just more prepared for it.
Every win counts. There was also a win on Tuesday night as the Runnin' Rebels played right here in the MGM Grand Garden, as well as they took on Oral Roberts.
The Runnin' Rebels broke their two-game skid as they ran with Oral Roberts Tuesday night at the Grand Garden Arena. Shakur Houston was strong early as he gets the inside bucket. Brandon McCoy made the power move to the hole for two and then knocked down a baseline jumper. But it was a sluggish start for UNLV, who struggled to generate offense, and Oral Roberts had the early lead. Houston kept the team in it almost single-handedly as he scored 17 points in the first half. The Rebs took the lead for good with 6:22 left in the first on this JoJo Mooring three. Jordy Johnson followed with a triple of his own, all part of a 16-1 Runnin' Rebel run that opened the lead up. Then the transition offense would pick up steam. On the run, Jordy feeds JoJo in stride for the trifecta. Just before the half, Chris Clyburn drives. He gets the friendly bounce on the rim, and it all hits before the buzzer as UNLV led 41-28 at the break. Things would pick up in the second half. McCoy with the follow slam. Chekna Dembele with some quality minutes as he gets the offensive rebound and put back. And that's when Amari Hardy got hot, sizzling hot, knocking down not one, not two, but three triples in a 3 minute stretch. He also played helper, beating McCoy, who slams it home. UNLV shoots 54% from the floor, and they pull away from Oral Roberts, 92-66.
We got a real good team. You know, had two tough losses. You know, we're not gonna let that define us. You know, as a team. So you know, we came into this game. You know, want to play just like they was Arizona. So we wanted to play with the same fire, not looking over this team.
We didn't see them being like, you know, a team that's 2-7. We just saw an opportunity to go out and bounce back the right way. We just came out. A little slow, but the coach got on us. We picked it up. We was a little down, but, you know, we didn't just let it tumble the whole game. We just had to find the right energy, find the right focus, and we did what we had to do.
So this was an important win because it was a bounce-back game coming off of two really difficult games
right.
to see how your guys responded. A little sluggish in the beginning,
right.
but, boy, they really picked things up about 5-6 minutes into the first half.
Right. I think players often emulate the coach. And I'll be honest with you. I felt a little out of sorts. I felt the stress a little bit myself, which is rare for me at this stage of the game. I don't usually get too wound up, but I felt like, you know, they followed my lead. I think I was a little wound up. I think they felt it, and I think I wound them up the wrong way. And then when, you know, I kind of settled down and said, hey, okay, this is what we need to do. Let's get to the nuts and bolts of what is actually going to give us the victory. They focused in. The energy picked up. We kept them doing things that they were comfortable doing and just playing our game and getting back into running and not overthinking the situation. And then that's when we were able to kind of put that one behind us.
Oral Roberts kind of ran a quirky type zone that I'm sure a lot of your guys maybe hadn't seen as much. And,
right.
And at some point, your players on your instruction just attacked.
Right.
How much does that benefit you going into the Mountain West Conference down the road that you might see something like that?
I don't know that we'll see that much based on the history of the coaches that are in the conference. I don't, you know, maybe Larry Stacy. We'll throw some stuff at you with this team. He's going to keep grasping for straws to right the ship with his guys. Don't think Dutch and San Diego State will do it. And I can go through the line. I don't think there's anybody that's going to run anything close to that. However, you're going to see some zone. And conceptual reactions to a zone and what helps you to beat a zone are the same, no matter whether it's a one-guard front, like a 1-3-1 or a 1-2-2, or whether it's a two-guard front. You've got to have a litany of things that you need to do in order to attack it successfully. And we did get that, and we got that look, and we had that opportunity.
Good week for the Rebels done. Coming up next in the Reb Zone, we're going to look to next week where there's only one game on the schedule, and it's on the road at Pacific. Plus, UNLV gives back this week to a special holiday tradition here in Las Vegas. The Reb Zone back in 2 minutes.
You're watching the Fox 5 Reb Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
On Friday, UNLV Athletics paid a visit to the 98.5 KLUC Toy Drive with Chet Buchanan and the crew. Coach Menzies joined by Director of Athletics Desiree Reed-Francois, the Rebel Girls, and Hey Reb, all to donate bikes, toys, and $30,000 in Runnin' Rebel and Lady Rebel tickets so families that might not be able to afford to can go to a game. It's all part of the Rebel Athletic community giving back to the Las Vegas community.
It's a dynamic community, but it's also a community that really cares about one another and that really helps one another. And I think you look around, you look at all of these toys and all these people here, it's just a testament to the spirit and the power of Las Vegas as a community.
How many families are going to have such an amazing time spending time together and doing what we do in Las Vegas, and that's going to Rebel games?
So it's always great to go out to Chet's event. I know you went out there last year,
right.
And this thing's just gotten bigger and better, and the Runnin' Rebels making sure that people get a chance to come out to maybe some games and put a smile on their face as well.
It is. I'm telling you, it's a really special event, and it's grown. I don't know, it's 7-8 years now maybe they've been doing it, and they just do a fantastic job. And when you think about the memories that are being created with those gifts, I mean, you can't duplicate that. You've got to get in those homes and take care of those kids. And if they don't get it from us, sometimes they don't get it. And from Chet and their group. So I thought it was a fantastic cause. And so we'll continue to support them in any way possible.
The Runnin' Rebels with just one game this week. They're in Stockton, California at Pacific on Saturday. A couple of familiar faces to Runnin' Rebel fans with this Pacific ball club. Damon Stoudemire, the head coach, of course, one of the great players in NCAA and had some time up in the NBA as well. And Justin Hawkins, a great former Runnin' Rebel, is on staff at Pacific.
Right.
What does this team bring? Because obviously they've brought in guys that have played the games and they're coaching these guys up.
Yeah, you know, Justin is obviously a Rebel, so, you know, you hate to play your friends. Damon's a good buddy of mine. He actually, when I was in Las Cruces, Damon came out as one of the celebrities for our golf tournament up there. And I think he's doing an excellent job up there. What he's done is he's started to put his stamp on the program, and he's brought in some young talent, and he's got a couple trickled in some experience, and they're competing a little bit earlier, I think, than people thought they were, and he'll grow that program for sure.
I know you'll get more into the videotape in terms of getting ready for the matchups to
right.
do practice. is it go back to one of these games, just like all of them, where you kind of have to do what you have to do out there?
You know, it will be, but as I get deeper into the scout and understand the specifics, then there could be some unique opportunities for us to learn and grow from. So, you know, until I get a little bit more out of that, I'll visit with you on that a little bit later off camera.
All right, sounds good. We're going to take another short break. We're going to come back. We're going to do a feature on the point guard for the Running Rebels this year, Jordy Johnson. Let you know what he brings to the table and why he has maybe an unusual song and artist choice to get him prepped for games. Stay with us.
You're watching the Fox 5 Rev Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie. Your home, your way.
The Running Rebels with a senior at the point guard position once again this year. Jordy Johnson has taken over the reins after sitting out last year from his transfer from Milwaukee, and he brings a lot to the table.
There's a new man running the point for the Running Rebels this season. Jordy Johnson is the first true point guard UNLV has had in several years, and his mindset is to pass first, but score if needed.
I'd rather make that pass than the play-tackling pass than me going scoring or driving, because I want to make that nice pass and get the crowd to go, ooh. I try to get my teammates involved as much as possible before I get going. So that way, everybody's happy, and then I just try to ease right in through the game. So just help my teammates. I want my teammates to look good, basically, that's it.
Johnson is a senior who transferred last year from Milwaukee, where he played under head coach and current UNLV assistant Rob Jeter. He had to sit out last year because of NCAA transfer rules, but was able to practice with the team, which allowed him to get the system down. Johnson likes what he sees from this year's Rebels.
I'm really excited because we got a lot of good players and a lot of high recruits. So I know that we are capable of doing something really special for this town.
Off the court, Johnson is a Call of Duty fanatic and even has some fierce battles with teammates.
Chris and JoJo, I'm always hoping on them.
Then there's music, something he considers a hobby, but his interests are wide-ranging. Everyone from Lil B to Taylor Swift.
Taylor Swift?
Yeah, Taylor Swift.
What about Taylor Swift that has her on the list?
She just make good music, that's all. I like her music.
Do the guys talk smack about that with you?
Oh, no. Nah. They know I listen to that, too, so sorry.
There won't be any Taylor Swift jokes as long as things are going good. And Johnson has a message for UNLV fans.
Make sure they be there, because it's going to be a fun show to watch. We're going to give them a show to watch.
When you talk about good basketball teams going into a season,
right,
senior point guard seems to be the common denominator, and this is a good one.
He's a fantastic player, and he's an even better person. He's one of those guys who got a quirky sense of humor. You know, when he's upbeat and positive and going, I mean, there's nobody more fun to be around. You know, he's got the guys now, I think, are kind of buying into. He's demanding, you know, so they're buying into his leadership. It took a little while because he'll bark at you. He doesn't always do it with a pleasant tone. And our guys' responses weren't always great. But now I think they're kind of figuring out, like, okay, he knows what he's doing. He's been here. You know, the guy was number two in the United States in assists a couple of years ago. So with that growth and that relationship growth, the chemistry, the collaboration, and the connectivity of the guys has been, you know, a big factor in us moving forward and being 8-2 at this point.
How important was having him sit out last year, which he had to by the NCAA rules, but he learned the system, so he was able to hit the ground running this year where a graduate transfer comes in and kind of you're starting from scratch in the same season. Big benefit?
Well, it was a benefit, there's no question, but it was more of a benefit of just the relationship or growing the relationship. The system is different. We're playing a little different style of ball, but some of the terminology is the same, the familiarity of the coaches, the growth and the continuity from staff and players that he did get a chance to engage with you know, Shaq and Chris Clyburn and JoJo and, you know, Ben and George and those guys. I mean, so it's more of a family when you have somebody that's been around for a little bit.
Have you in your career ever had a player that listens to Taylor Swift as pump up music before a game?
This might be a first. I think I know some cheerleaders that use that, but I've never seen a player use it.
So if he flips it on there in the locker room before you go out, you say whatever?
We're a headphones only group, man. I'm never going to hear Taylor Swift before a game. No knock on Taylor, but no, we make sure they're all in their own little zones. We don't play the group music thing.
All right, thanks, Coach. We're going to take one final break. We're coming back with some final thoughts from Coach Menzies and the Run Rebels Plays of the Week right after this.
You're watching the Fox 5 Rev Zone Sports Show, presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.
All right, Coach, have a great week. Good luck. We'll see you in Stockton on Saturday. And thank you for joining us in the Rev Zone. We leave you with the Run Rebels Plays of the Week. Good night.
Rev Zone Sports Show was presented by RC Willie, your home, your way.